Hey guys, it's Tom from EverydayGamers.com, and I have a video update for you today. This is actually a game room update. I know it's been a couple days since I posted any videos. Just haven't really had any video game related, purchases or anything lately. Money's been a little bit tight. I'm in between, well, not really in between jobs. I'm finishing up the one job, and I'm going to be moving on to this next job here within the next few weeks, which will provide me some more funds so that I can buy some more video games. You all know how it is. But I do have a little bit of an update for you today. Like I said, this is a game room update. I guess this is the third game room video that I've done so far. And just something that I did as far as a little bit of an addition to my game room. And wanted to share that with you guys, see what you all thought about it. It's not complete by any means. This game room of mine is like a work in progress. It's always, I don't know if it'll ever be complete. I'll probably end up moving before it's complete, and then I'm going to have to pack everything up and start all over again wherever me and my wife end up. But for the time being, let me go ahead and just show you guys what I did and the additions that I've made to the game room. So over on this wall here is basically, this is where the changes have taken place. As you can see, I don't know if you can tell too well, but this is all slot board, and I went ahead and I actually screwed this into the wall. But what happened was a couple weeks ago, I was at work and I noticed that we had this sitting in the back and it wasn't being used. So, I started to think, that I could definitely use this in my game room, and I wanted to use it for shelving, and that's exactly what I've done. So I've kind of put it up there. Now, the color of it right now, I don't think I'm going to keep it that color. I'm planning on maybe doing something artistic, hopefully. Maybe a little bit of a paint scheme, put in some logos, like a 360 logo and like a PlayStation logo, something like that. But we'll see what happens. But I did, make this change here. So if you don't know what, if you haven't seen the other videos, go back and check that out and you can see how this corner has changed. But this is the game room layout, so you get an idea of where that is in perspective to the room. I've had a lot of different people ask me some questions about my game room. The one that I get, quite often is actually, how did I get the PlayStation 2 kiosk? And I believe that I explained it before. However, I'll explain it again. The way that I got this is, I was a manager at GameStop, and near the end of my working relationship with GameStop, they told all managers to actually pull this off of the floor, or at least they told my store to pull this off of the floor. So once they pulled it off of the floor and it was back in the back room for a few months, I decided and I took it upon myself to take it home with me. what they did before was they did the same thing with the GameCube kiosk that we had there. Unfortunately, I wasn't around. My employees didn't even tell me that they were advised to take it off and to remove it from the floor, and they told us to go ahead and just throw it out. So what happened was that ended up being trashed, and lo and behold, I got nothing out of it. So when this went into the back room and it was there for a little while, I said to myself, look, I want this. I'm gonna go ahead and just take it, and I took it. So it was the least of what I thought, GameStop owed to me. I'm not a thief, but they weren't going to use it. They would end up throwing it out anyways. So, just give you guys another view of my game room. Now, I do have actually one more of these panels here, these slapboard panels, and I'll show you. It's back here behind this. It's not mounted or anything, and I don't have really anywhere else to mount it at this point. You'll notice that there's a gap between these two, and the reason why there is that gap there is obviously one, there was going to be a gap because I couldn't fit it. This is between my window and the wall over here. So I couldn't fit them together without there being some sort of gap. The other thing is, I had to make sure that I could find the studs so that I mounted this and I didn't come home and have all my stuff laying on the floor like I have in the past. But I'll show you what I use for shelves. This is also something that we had laying in the back room. Let me just pull this off here for now. It's just these acrylic shelves here, and they snap right on there and snap right into place. So yeah, that's what I'm using right now. Now, this isn't a complete layout right now, or this isn't a final setup like I mentioned. I'm going to change this up, but for the time being, I wanted to throw some stuff up there to give you guys an idea. I also have quite a few of these baskets right here, and I'm planning on doing something with wire cutters and cutting these off, and maybe eventually just putting, you know, some video games up here. I also got a couple of these here, which are really good for my strategy guides. You can see that I have a couple of strategy guides here, and I have the MGS4 PlayStation official magazine, still in the shrink wrap there, but this is the God of War 2 strategy guide, Resident Evil 4, and then Ninja Gaiden Sigma. I just put that stuff up there for now, and then the Digital Devil Saga, and also Devil Summoner 2. And then I just put a couple of these. I had some loose DVDs that I couldn't fit on the shelf, or I couldn't fit in this rack here, and I threw them in here. So for the time being, this is it, guys. I don't know what I'm going to do. I just decided to put some of my Perler bead sprites up there to kind of fill in the gap and to make it look a little bit cleaner, I guess you would say. But for the time being, that's the way it's going to be. It didn't come out perfect by any means, but it actually works really well, and I kind of like the way it looks. It makes me feel like I have a little bit of a, like a, my own game store here in this corner, which maybe one day I'll have my own game store. You can see I put the God of War poster that I had over here. I put it over here right now next to Heavenly Sword, Noriko. You know, you got the God of War and the Goddess of War, whatever. And the two posters that were actually right there above the DVD rack are now down here. Call of Duty Modern Warfare and Call of Duty, or well, Modern Warfare 2, which is now not Call of Duty. And last but not least, the last addition to the game room was this Batman Arkham Asylum poster, which if you've been in a GameStop in the last, I guess, month it was, they had this on display. And I was in a GameStop, and I got really pissed off because the employees refused to return a game that wasn't working for me. So on my way out, I ripped this off of the front window and just took it with me. Walked right out of the store. No, I'm only kidding. If you guys know, I'm a friend of one of the managers at GameStop, and I asked him if I could have it when they took it down, and he gave it to me. So that's it, guys. That's my game room update. Hope you enjoyed. I will be bringing you some more content. I plan on doing a video every day, and sometimes it doesn't happen just because of, you know, all of the busyness of life. You guys know how that is. But I want to make sure that I'm bringing you, you know, some new content on a regular basis, and hopefully you guys are enjoying that. But thanks again for watching, and I will bring you guys a video again soon.